meeting to order, 7:30 on Monday, November 6th. And we're here to review the preliminary tax rate and if we're ready to set the final tax rate for the town. So in order to make all of this happen, we had to review revenues one final time with DRA, which I did sometime last week. The school had to submit its paperwork and all this sort of stuff, and the water district had to submit its paperwork. And we had to run the MS-1 with our new overall tax property valuation. So with all of that, the tax base is now over 279.5 million. And with all of that, including what we plan to put, use the fund balance, we have a tax rate of $23.28 as the preliminary rate. Much of the increase is from the county. So if we look at, it was an increase of more than 25%.
The county, oh, yeah.
Yes, so this is, let me find the tax after. So the county, here's the county, 733,000. Last year it was 120-some-odd thousand less. So I don't know what they were doing in the county. I think their CIP had an increase. So given, this is our current, our current unassigned fund balance at the end of the process, 8.7. And what else do we look at? This has the tax base. Take a look at the particular piece that each of us is contributing, the municipal, the county. And I don't know why, but the state ed has a different tax, has a different property valuation base. So I don't know what constitutes the difference, but it's somewhat less than the rest of us. But this went down, this is down, we're up a little bit, the county is up a lot. So that's the source of that. So the overlay will keep the same at 25,000, unless there's some wanting, some indication we want to do otherwise. But this is what the preliminary rate looks like. And it's at $23.28. Our tax burden, so I can show you, our tax burden has increased 2.1%. So what I have done, again, we haven't agreed to the rate, but what I have done, and I can just change the numbers accordingly, is we can either, if there's time, insert this with the tax bill, understanding your 2017 tax bill. So right now, this is using the rates that are in the preliminary, which we haven't agreed to yet. So this is, the 2017 tax rate has changed from $27.98 to $23.28, a decrease of $4.70. But your tax bill has likely gone up. How come? So our overall tax burden or tax effort is the amount of money that we need to raise from taxes. And our 2017 tax burden is increased by 2.1%, which with much of the increase due to the county. Stratford County tax burden or effort grew by more than 25% or over $122,000. With the revale process conducted over the past year, our overall town valuation increased by almost 23%, from $227.7 million to $279.5 million. So how to make sense of your tax bill and your new assessed value? If your overall 2017 tax bill has increased by more than 2.1%, which is the increase of the tax burden, then the value of your property has increased more than the average Rollinsford property. If your overall 2017 tax bill has decreased, then the value of your property has decreased relative to the average Rollinsford property.
Well said.
So we can plug in whatever we decide to do with numbers, we can just make those changes to that document. So let's go back to the So any discussion on this, on the proposed, on the preliminary tax rate that the DRA has set? $23.28.
I have a portion that we have to go over.
This. 3.24.
Four times
In a tax rate.
How much, right, overall, right, but how much of that attributable to the municipal?
I think it's a little over five.
Municipal?
Mm-hmm, yep. But the bulk of it is coming here with the county.
Alright. I've been building over there in Dover, but I hope it was nice. Good luck. What are the fund balance, what we're putting in the fund balance, 25, is it? Or the overlay is 25?
Mm-hmm.
And fund balance at 8.1, yeah?
Um. It's, it will be 8.7%, so the range is 5% to 17%.
Try to stay in the, right in the middle, it's still prudent.
And this is what we were sort of planning on putting in, $200,000.
In the fund balance.
Pardon? That's 9.3, and the tax rate is $23.46. What's better?
I just don't wanna take up too much of the fund balance, if we can help it.
Well, so the fund balance is, so the range is 5% to 17%, so we're well within, well within the range, even at the 8.7%. And this coming year, we're already planning on reducing what we put in from fund balance because of some of the other sources of revenue that we have. So, I mean, it's there to help keep taxes, it's there for emergencies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we still have, we would have, you know, whatever it was, almost 900,000. It was 800 and, I don't remember what it was. So, we would have, we would have 708. So I was wrong. I don't think that was when we did the, let me see what it is with. It's different between 708 and 758. I was looking at this up here, which is wrong. Well, what are my thoughts? So if we increase the tax rate because we don't put as much fund balance, and if we say, okay, we're trying to keep it within a 2%, let's say, increase. So now we've got a bigger base, so actually we're going to spend, we would end up being able to spend more money in 2018,
right,
theoretically, you know, based on that. So if we take some of our, the fund balance that we had planned, keep the tax rate at a 2.1% increase, and now if we're trying to be disciplined and keep it to within 2%, it's less of a tax burden, actually, you know.
Right.
So you've used the, you know, it's a little bit payment out, payment later, it kind of, but nonetheless, if you're trying to keep your, trying to find a way to discipline yourself.
Right.
So it, so that's the difference. We'd start with a If we raise the tax rate right now, we'd start actually with a bigger platform upon which to apply next year, you know, next year's. But, you know, it's.
I'd like to live within the 2%. Keeping things.
So it would be easier for us to live within 2% if we, you know, through, if we only did 150,000 in fund balance and raised the tax rate now. So now we've got an elevated, more elevated tax rate. So now the 2%. Do you understand? Okay. So that, I mean, that's kind of the difference. Either way, we've got fund balance within the range, retained fund balance within the range that the DRA is comfortable. Is there anything else I can show you, you can see that would be helpful? All right, let me just try something.
So then I'm taking the extra five out of fund balance. Give us a rate of what?
50, the extra?
50, sorry.
50,000?
50, sorry.
It gave us a tax rate. Let's see where we are.
With 200, we're at 23.28.
Yes, and now we need $23.46. And let me just... Let me just try something here. Give me a minute. So these figures, I'm still working on the 10-year projections based on some of this new information. So right now I've got a base, this is the tax effort for the town at 906,000, which is what it is if we use the 200,000. So if we put that, what is it? Here. You know, it looks like we have a 5% decrease in 2018 in our budget because we're as a percentage increase over this somewhat higher platform. So that's these, I think, an essential difference. Either way, we're within the range, the advisable range of our retained fund balance, either using 200,000, using 150,000. We're within their advisable range, or recommended range. It'll make the 2018 budget look somewhat easier. It will, instead of 2.1% increase, what do we have in our effort? You can't see this. I'm just talking about. No, that's small. Sorry about that. So, I have the old tax in there. So the tax. So if this, hang on just a minute, 950, what is it there, $3.42. No, it's the tax effort. So now the tax rate increases 2.9% instead of 2.1.
With the reduction down?
Yes, yep. The rate doesn't, but your tax burden.
Right.
So it's a 2.9% increase versus 2.1. And so if we do 3%, okay, or almost 3%, and we say, yeah, well, we don't want to increase, we're not going to use that as a base, even though we can, then we'll attack. What you're trying to do is avoid this,
exactly.
You know, this sort of thing.
Right.
So if we're staying sort of like in the 2% range, I think that's a...
I'm more comfortable with that. I'd rather go with that. Just stay within the 2% range.
All right, so... Let me go back. Let's get it. I'm not going to press the button today, by the way, because this morning, I will when I go home, once
right.
We decide it.
Right.
All right, so let's put this back then. All right, 23 and 28. All right, so... I will entertain a motion then to accept the DRA's preliminary tax rate of $23.28.
Second.
Any further discussion or questions on that? All right. All those in favor say aye.
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 Thank you for giving me the poll, of course.
My pleasure. There are actually ways in which it's helpful in our working on our budget
right.
Because. The other kind of sort of ratio proportion thing that we were using to try to assess tax rates
yeah.
Isn't quite as precise as this, so
right.
this is helpful to use this going forward. All right, is there any other business that you think we need to attend to that can't wait? I will just say, Kelwyn Drive, I think we need to hear from George
okay.
About, I guess, because we have to decide by tomorrow morning. So, so that's one of the things we're going to have to do tonight is hopefully he'll have some information and decide whether we're going to go ahead with Kelwyn or not.
Okay.
And I know where the money's coming from and how to deal with it. Not that we're going to want to do it regardless, but just how that works with this year's budget and management.
Okay.
All right? Excellent. Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right, 6 o'clock? We're still doing
6 o'clock, yes. We've got the prospective ordinance.
All right.
I'm just going to log out. I can say it's okay. 7:48.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
See you tonight. 6 o'clock. Oh, boy.